you can be Ndamukong Suh or Aaron Donald. Now, you know you got to put pressure on Brady, which is easier said than done.
Right.
But how do you – you got pressure on yourself of putting pressure on Brady, because if you don't get it, he's going to kill you.
If I could be either one of those guys this week, I'd want to be Ndamukong Suh. So I play with Warren Sapp. I think Warren Sapp is the best, maybe at worst, second best defensive tackle ever to play the game behind John Randall. His words, not mine, so I'm going to agree with him. There's going to be a lot of attention paid to Aaron Donald. You know, Belichick is, people always say, well, he takes what you do best and takes it away. Well, don't most coaches, I mean, shouldn't most coaches do that?
Yeah.
And so Bill's not going to allow Aaron to wreck this game. Last time that the Patriots and Rams played, Aaron Donald had three tackles, one quarterback hit. He was a non-factor. That was December 2016. I think you're going to see a similar production sheet. He's a better player. Bill's a better coach. Shaq Mason is a better guard. So now, you can't double everybody. So who gets the one-on-ones? Fowler, he's going against a guy that's 6'8 and like a mountain at left tackle. So the guy that has to be dominant is Ndamukong Suh.
Yeah.
He's going to get one-on-one blocks. And for all the things that we made out of him coming out of Nebraska, should have won the Heisman, he's been a dominant player. By and large, I've been disappointed with his career because I think it should have been better. Now, the last couple of weeks, he has turned it on, and when he turns it on, he is a son of a gun. He is tough to deal with. He's got to be that way Sunday. If he's that way, I don't think that the Patriots can block that front four. But it's on Ndamukong Suh, not Aaron Donald.
He can change his entire career perception in one day.
Yeah.
If he won the Super Bowl, if he was a big reason why they won the Super Bowl, we'll look at him differently.
Three sacks, forced fumble, and we forget about the personal foul. We forget about some of the dumb plays that he's made. We forget about kind of how he forced his way out of Detroit a little bit, and he becomes a hero. We remember people that win on Sunday.
Yeah.
We don't remember the loser.
Yeah.
And I think that's the mindset that players have to have going into this game. The game's the same. It's 60 minutes. But it's the hoopla around the game that's going to change. And the team that makes it more normal and goes out and performs the best, I think it's going to win. And I'm going to lean toward the Rams right now just because I have faith that the Ndamukong Suh I've seen the last 2 weeks, I'm going to see. And I can't see the Todd Gurley I've seen for the last month. I think Todd Gurley is going to show back up, who's been one of the more productive players, the most productive running back in the league the last 2 years.
For more Dan Patrick Show, tune to Audience Channel 239 on DirecTV or download the Dan Patrick Show app.